Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. What exactly are organometallics? Any molecule that contains a carbon-metal bond is an organometallic reagent. Okay, let's talk more about this carbon-metal bond. And to frame our discussion, let's first focus on oxygen-metal bonds. You have certainly encountered lots of oxygen metal bonds. Sodium hydroxide, as an example, has a bond between oxygen and sodium, normally because of the high difference in electronegativity between oxygen and sodium. This bond is represented as an ionic bond. You have an O minus and sodium plus. Very few people would draw sodium hydroxide as having a covalent NaO bond. The ionic picture better describes the basicity and nucleophilicity of the oxygen. So most people stick with the ionic O minus representation. Let's now look at an organometallic structure with a carbon metal bond. Note that M equals a metal. It's kind of like X equals a halogen. The difference in electronegativity between carbon and a metal, any metal, is not as large as oxygen and a metal. Therefore, it's less clear whether the CM bond should be drawn as ionic or covalent. In general, even with the least electronegative metals, the carbon metal bonds are most accurately depicted as covalent. But in terms of reactivity, just as with hydroxide, we are going to treat organometallic reagents as strong bases and nucleophiles. Therefore, when I show organometallic species, that the ones that we'll see in this playlist, I will show them as ionic structures. A carbanion and a positive metal. The covalent representation might be more accurate. But the ionic representation, the carbanion, is more useful. In terms of showing reaction mechanisms and remembering reactivity. You may have already encountered acetylides in organic chemistry. Let's draw one to the very far right. These are actually organometallic reagents. They involve a carbon metal bond. Most people, when they show an acetylide, almost always a sodium acetylide, the acetylide is shown with the ionic carbon sodium bond. The ionic representation highlights the idea that acetylides are strong nucleophiles. Again, the covalent picture may be more accurate, but the ionic picture is more helpful for our purposes.